Pāua are like little divas, super fragile. They need everything to be perfect. If the water is too cold, too hot, too salty, not salty enough, dead. One cut and they'll bleed to death. Haemophiliac. So Pāua are super fragile, super special.
Getting a feed of Pāua around Waiheke Island is a thing of the past.
No one for many years has gathered legal sized Pāua.
In fact, Pāua are on the verge of disappearing altogether.
The fact that their species are all declining at such a rapid, remarkable rate is all the evidence you need.
But the combination of Western science expertise and mātauranga Māori, along with a determined iwi, is bringing hope.
If we don't do something now, what's left in there will also disappear.
Māori legend says Tangaroa, the god of the sea, hid the beauty of the Pāua's inner shell with a drab, rough cover to protect it from the envy of other sea creatures. Today, there are far more threats to its survival in the wild around Waiheke Island.
A lot of our taonga species that we were raised on and brought up on that we just expected would be there is no longer available. And that's devastating for us as an iwi, but particularly for future generations, to think that my mokopuna would never experience certain kai.
In 2021, Ngāti Paoa placed a two-year rāhui on gathering kaimoana around Waiheke, including Pāua.
We discover that there's less than 200 Pāua, and all of them are undersized, and which is why we put the rāhui down.
But numbers continue to fall.
Imagine life without kaimoana. That's our DNA, that's our whakapapa, that's our everything.
A more extreme approach was needed. At dawn, a team sets off from Auckland Harbour to Waiheke. It includes marine ecologist Kura Paul-Burke from Waikato University.
Pāua are massively important to the ecosystem. As they're so fragile, if Pāua are not thriving, that's a tohu that their habitat is degraded.
With Kura is her husband Joe, a marine advisor, and Ngāti Paoa iwi members like Herearoha Skipper. They're part of Pou Rāhui, a project where five Hauraki Gulf iwi are restoring kaimoana. It's taken 2 years to get to this point. It began with interviews of iwi members to identify, then map the areas where Ngāti Paoa harvested Pāua.
Our team were able to go out and go directly to those areas to do the population count is through the mātauranga.
The team also spent weeks clearing 11 hectares of kina barrens around Waiheke.
Part of the reason they're unhealthy is kina.
The decline of crayfish and snapper has led to an excess of kina.
So they're starting to creep in shallow and compete for space and kai. So the Pāua are being made homeless and they're having no food. Part of preparing the house was that we removed 5,000 kina, and that's an ongoing thing. Like, you know, when you clean your house, you don't just clean it once, we wish. But you've got to keep going back. The Pāua population was so in such a dire, functionally extinct state that we needed experts who were able to not only care for our Pāua and whakapiki tā rātou Māori, because they were unhealthy. So we needed to get them healthy enough to see if they could make babies. Could we take boys and girls to what we called the Pāua Hospital, which for us was the Arapawa Sea Farms? The logistics were immense.
TLC at the Marlborough facility worked.
What was really astounding was when they were in the Pāua Hospital, some of them grew up to 28 millimetres in a year. So that's how important their whare or their habitat is to not only their growth rates, but also their ability to reproduce.
The result was thousands of baby Pāua.
Pāua, they're broadcast spawners, so there's no dating, no movies, no dinner. the boys just shoot their sperm into the water column, and the girls, deeply disappointed, release their eggs. And then the sperm and eggs come together and make babies. They are so tiny that millions can fit onto one teaspoon. They're pretty cool.
And today the team is reseeding 80,000 baby pāua.
That's got to be 1,500 right there. That's a huge bag.
Everyone matters. You never know which one's going to make it.
Four secret sites around Waiheke have been prepared.
This is also the same area where we cleaned the house, the whare, and we removed all the kina. So the pāua, our hukupuna, have a good chance here.
When I think of pāua, I don't think of them as some alien foreign species. I think of them as my whanaunga, as my kin. Just like we do with our mokopuna, with our grandchildren, we try to feed them up, give them good shelter. It's the same concept. We create a kohanga, or nest, to house some of the mokopuna as a refuge. They are just like big cages with holes so they can go in and out at will, but that way, because they hide away for so long, we want to be able to go back and monitor them. When we put them into the ocean, Ngāti Paoa already had that protection in place for them to adapt, acclimatise, grow and stabilise a future population. So that mātauranga Māori in terms of rāhui is pivotal to this project.
So, like, you just went and increased the population by 36,000%.
The regeneration of pāua by Ngāti Paoa also extends to its younger generation.
Nobody knows their water better than the locals. Nobody. And part of that working with Ngāti Paoa, with the iwi, is their youth. They know their water because they're in it all the time with us. They're part of this work to change. Accepting what we are now is unacceptable, really. We trained up young people and they've been in the water with us always.
We are the whānei. We are the giving back to the taiao.
They have participated and observed how to do pāua population surveys. And also their job in the water is to document what fish are present, what types of kelp is there, etc. That's to ensure a connected responsibility for our young people and them one of the future.
So they're at university now doing marine science. We've had ones that have done their masters. We've had Taiohi gone off to learn te reo Māori, so it grounds that mātauranga. One of the things that's really important within our iwi is becoming practitioners of that knowledge so that we can bring our moana back into balance and retain that whakapapa of those taonga species.
We don't have to live with a dying ocean. We really don't. We don't have to give up. Tūmanako, there's always hope, but hope must come with action.
For more hui content, subscribe to our YouTube channel.